on the prone positioning and draping techniques. So we already started by washing hands before introductions were made. Hi, I'm Katie Backus. I'll be your physical therapist today. And what's your name?
Hi, I'm Sam Thompson.
Sam Thompson. Awesome. And when's your birthday?
12/28/1991.
Very nice to meet you. So today we're going to be treating your lower back. So in order to do so, we're going to need you lying in a prone position on this table. So in that position, you'll be lying on your front, face down on the pillow.
Okay.
So right here for you, I have two pillows. The pink one will be placed underneath your forehead, and then I have this white one, and if you want to place it right on your lower abdomen, make it a little more comfortable for you.
Okay.
Also, I have a sheet placed here for you. So I'm going to leave the room for just a minute. If you want to go ahead and remove your shirt at that time, and then drape yourself, just cover yourself with the sheet.
Okay.
And when I get back in, we'll be able to get started with your treatment.
All right.
Do you have any questions?
Nope.
Does that
good.
All sound good to you?
Yep.
Okay, awesome, Sam. I'll be right back.
All right, perfect.
All right, I'm just going to be explaining the positioning of where we're putting the pillows and the towels to support the body in the prone position. It's going to reduce soft tissue stress, and it's going to support and stabilize the joints that's laying prone. So first, we start with a small pillow under the forehead. This is going to support the neck so they can put their head to the right or left, and or it can be placed under the forehead. And it's going to put the neck in a slightly flexed position. And the second one is going to be placed under the lower abdomen. It's going to prevent excessive lumbar lordosis. And then the third one is going to be placed under each scapula. This is going to put the scapulas in a slightly adducted position, and it's going to protect the head of the humerus. And then the final one is going to be placed under the ankles, and this is going to protect the ankles, and it's going to put the knee at a slightly flexed position, and this is going to help with the hamstrings. With this position, it can be a contracture site because of the flexed knee. Another alternative is to protect the patellas by placing towels under the thighs instead, and it can give that area a little rest. And then for the upper extremity, you're just going to position for comfort. So it can be placed your arms in a T position under their head, forehead, or by their sides, whatever works for them.
Sam, you ready?
Yep.
Okay, awesome. All right, before we get started, I'm going to place these towel rolls under some of your pressure points to relieve some of that stress, make it a little more comfortable for you. So if you want to lean up, these are going to be going underneath your shoulders. There you go. Also, I have this bigger towel roll. It's going to go right underneath your ankle. So if you want to lift your feet a little, slide that under. Okay, now we're going to need to expose that low back. So I'm just going to fold this sheet down to get to that area. If you want to move your arm just a little. All right, we're going to pull that down. Is this position feel okay for you?
Yeah.
Awesome. If you get uncomfortable at any point, just let me know. We can add some more towel rolls to some of those pressure points. And also, feel free to move your arms in any position that you wish most comfortable. In Sam's example, he was able to drape himself without assistance while he left the room. Other cases may not be the same. So in that case, if someone needs assistance in draping themselves or removing clothing, make sure to ask. First, ask consent to make sure the patient's comfortable with that. Also, respect their modesty and only expose the areas needed for treatment.